Yes, good afternoon, students. So today we will discuss converter fault and protection. So generally, if you see that basic layout of the AC/DC transmission line. It will be at first of all here it will be generating station. Then after that there is a transformer, that is generating step up transformer. Transformer one, that is the step up transformer. Then after this there is a converter station one. Converter station one. Then input to this converter station one is AC, output to it is DC. That means this converter station act will be act as rectifier, right? Now this converter station, after this there will be actually DC transmission line. Then after that there is converter station 2. Right, here it will be input to converter station 2, that will be DC, and output of it, that will be AC. That means it will be act as equivalent to inverter. Right, here transformer 1 is step up transformer. And transformer 2, here it will be with a place transformer 2 here, that will be step down transformer, right? And here it will be the load center. So this is the basic layout of the AC/DC transmission line. If you see in this AC/DC transmission line, basically they are different from this AC transmission line only in the way of converter station. In case of AC transmission, in case of AC transmission, there is no need of the converter stations, because whatsoever voltage we will get it here at the generating station, that will be generally 11.6 volt. That will be step up with the help of that transformer, and that high voltage will be transmitted throughout anywhere in the world or anywhere in India, right? So because due to some of the major advantages in case of long distance transmission line, we will prefer to use AC/DC transmission over the AC transmission line, right? So basic difference between the AC and the DC transmission line is presence of the two converter station. Now converter station 1, that will be act as equivalent to rectifier. As we are aware that this rectifier is a device which will convert AC into DC. Rectifier is a device which will convert AC into DC. So at the converter station 1, this will be act as equivalent to the rectifier. Input to it is AC and output of the circuit is DC. Now further, there are two types of the rectifier. One is controlled rectifier and another is uncontrolled rectifier. Controlled rectifier and uncontrolled rectifier, and similar is the case for this inverter circuit. Controlled inverter and uncontrolled inverter. So whenever I am talking about control, this word will comes in my mind from the working of thyristor or SCR, right? SCR is silicon control rectifier, or it is also known as thyristor, right? So thyristor is a device the output of which may control by giving the gate pulse at different interval, right? If we are providing this gate pulse at a phase angle of 0 degree, then it will be act as equivalent to diode, right? And if we will give some gate pulse other than the 0 degree at some other angle of alpha, anode, cathode and gate, right? If we are providing this gate pulse other than 0 degree angle, then this rectifier or inverter that are known as controlled rectifier or controlled inverter. Further, if instead of all the SCR or all the diode, we are using half diode and half SCR. Let us suppose in case of the full wave center tap rectifier, full wave center tap rectifier, we are using one diode and one silicon control rectifier, right? Then that will be known as half controlled rectifier. Uncontrolled, half control and fully control. In case of the uncontrolled, we are using diode only. There is no application of the SCR or thyristor if that rectifier or inverter is uncontrolled rectifier or uncontrolled inverter, right? On the other hand, if it is a controlled rectifier or controlled inverter, then all the thyristor, all the diode will be replaced by thyristor. All the diode will be replaced by thyristor. And if it will be half control, then in that case, we are using half the diode and half the SCR or thyristor. Right. So my mean to discuss all that is only difference between the HVDC transmission line and AC transmission line is presence of the converter. So if in any case fault will occur in the converter station, this will cause your line to be break or your supply to be break, right? So we will have to study this various types of the converter faults and its protection, right? Now, there are three different types. There are three basic type or different types of the fault that can occur in converter. One is fault due to malfunction of the valve and controller. Fault due to malfunction of valve and controller. Second is that malfunctioning. First is malfunctioning, second is commutation failure in inverter. Commutation failure in inverter. And third is short circuit in converter station. Short circuit in converter station. Right, so these are three different types. These are three different types of the fault. One is fault due to malfunction of the valves and controller. Second is commutation failure. And third is short circuit in converter station. Right. So in AC system, first of all, in AC system, the faults in DC system are caused by that first is that failure of the insulation caused by the external source, and second is malfunctioning of the equipment and controller. Now, fault due to malfunction of the valve and controller, that may be arc back in or backfire in the mercury arc valve. This type, this may be backfire in mercury arc valve. Now, first of all, you must aware that nowadays we are not using this mercury arc valve. We are not using mercury arc valve. Mercury arc valve is old type of device. Mercury arc valve is old type of device which may be used in the previous year, right? After this mercury arc valve, we will shift to the diode, and then after that, we will shift to the thyristor. So, mercury arc valve is the old type, you may say old type of the fashion, right? Second is fire through. That means we are providing fire through. We are providing the gate pulse continuously, right? And third cause for this is misfire. That means I am applying the gate pulse, right? I am applying the gate pulse, but that gate pulse is not sufficient to turn the device on. That is known as misfire. And fourth is quenching or current extinction. Quenching और करंट एक्सटिंक्शन. सो करंट एक्सटिंक्शन इज और क्वेंचिंग इज ड्यू टू द इंडक्टिव नेचर ऑफ द लोड. ड्यू टू द इंडक्टिव नेचर ऑफ द लोड करंट विल कॉन्टिन्यू टू फ्लो इन द सर्किट. राइट, ड्यू टू इंडक्टिव नेचर ऑफ द लोड करंट विल कॉन्टिन्यू टू फ्लो इन द सर्किट, बट वी आर अज्यूमिंग दैट दिस डिवाइस इज अंडर द ऑफ स्टेट. राइट, सो द आर्क बैक इज द फेलियर ऑफ द वाल्व टू ब्लॉक द रिवर्स डायरेक्शन एंड रिजल्ट इन ए टेम्पररी डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द रेक्टिफाइंग प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ द वाल्व ड्यू टू कंडक्शन इन द रिवर्स डायरेक्शन. फर्स्ट इज दैट आर्क बैक इज दैट करंट विल बी कंडक्टेड इन द रिवर्स डायरेक्शन. राइट, सो जनरली व्हाट विल हैपन इन केस ऑफ द रेक्टिफायर, वी नीड द करंट इन ए यूनिट डायरेक्शन, इन ए सिंगल डायरेक्शन. बट व्हेन दैट बैकफायर विल अकर, दैट मींस देयर विल बी नो आउटपुट लाइक ए रेक्टिफायर. राइट, देन दिस इज द मेजर फॉल्ट इन मर्करी आर्क वाल्व एंड दिस इज ऑफ द रैंडम नेचर. दिस इज रैंडमली अकर. This is a non-self-clearing fault and result in severe stresses on the transformer winding as the incident of the arc back is common. Right? So this type of the fault will occur in case of this mercury arc valve. Right? And this will be generally occur, randomly occur. And this will be not a self-clearing type fault. This is not a self-clearing type fault. Fine. And what will happen? This may cause that various types of the stresses on the various types of the stresses on the this transformer. Due to this backfire that stresses will be occur on the transformer winding. Right, now fortunately, thyristors do not suffer from arc back, as we had already discussed that thyristor or SCR that will not cause for the occurrence of the backfire. Backfire will only occur in case of that mercury arc valve, but in case of the thyristor there will be no such thing happening. Right, so this is our good luck that in present scenario we are using thyristor only. Even we are not preferred to use diode. So this kind of the fault will not occur in present HVDC transmission line. And that's why stress on the winding of the transformer will not occur. because this stress is due to that back fire of the mercury arc valve, right? Now some of the converter faults, such as commutation failure, arc through, and misfire, are self clearing if the causes that led to these fault are transient in nature. Rest three fault, that means commutation failure, then this short circuit, these may be a self clearing type fault if this will be occur due to transient. There are two types of the behavior of the any machine or any transmission line. One is steady state, and the second is that one is steady state and second is transient. Steady state is normal condition, right? And transients are abnormal condition, but that may cause clear sometime without any extra effort, right? Now come to the second part, that is a commutation failure. Now first of all, if you compare AC with DC, there is a corona loss, right? That will occur in both of the cases. No doubt in one case it will be more, in second case it will be less, right? Similarly, skin effect, that will be occur in both of the cases. The only thing is, in case of the HVDC line, due to presence of the converter station, cost of the system will increase. Cost of the system will increase, and it will cause, cost of the system will increase, and this will cause for the line to make uneconomical, right? But again, if you see for long distance HVDC transmission line, that economical factor will be also converted into the that range. For the long distance transmission line, that will not be uneconomical, that will become economical, right? But when you try HVDC transmission line for the short or medium length transmission line, then they will be uneconomical due to presence of the converter station, because converter stations are the major component. Converter stations are the major component for this HVDC transmission line, and its cost is quite high, and that may cause for your system to make uneconomical, right? Now next I am just going to discuss that commutation failure. So because of the turn of time requirement of thyristor, there is need to maintain a minimum value of the extinction angle, that is gamma is equal to 180 minus alpha minus mu. We will have to maintain this firing angle, extinction angle, as this gamma is equal to 180 minus alpha minus mu, right? Where alpha is the firing angle and mu is the overlap angle. Alpha is the firing angle and mu is the overlap angle, right? The overlap angle is the function of commutation voltage and DC current, right? The overlap angle is a function of commutation voltage and DC current. This the production in the voltage increase in the current, or both can result in increase in the overlap angle, right? The firing angle of the next valve will result in the short circuit of the bridge, right? Depending upon the firing angle of the next valve, short circuit may occur, right? Now this some of the effects of a single commutation failure, some of the effects of a single commutation failure are, first is that the bridge voltage remain zero, bridge voltage remain zero for some time period, right? Now this time period is for the period exceeding 1/3 of a cycle, during which DC current tends to increase, right? This is the time period that that is exceeding 1/3 of a cycle, and during which DC current tends to increase. And the second is, there is no AC current, there is no AC current for some time. There is no AC current for some time, and that time is in which the two valve in the arm are left conducting, right? Now recovery from the commutation failure, recovery from the commutation failure may be due to these factor, may be due to this factor. First is response of the gamma controller at the inverter. Second is current control in the link. And third is magnitude of the AC voltage, right? These are the three factor which may affect your this recovery from the commutation failure. Now if on detection of the commutation failure the angle of advance beta is increased, there is a good chance that subsequent commutation failure may be averted, right? So basically commutation failure may cause short circuit, right? And this may be due to these various reasons, right? And recovery will be dependent upon three factors, One is response of the gamma controller at the inverter. Second is current control in the link. And third is magnitude of the AC voltage, right? Now, next is what is current extinction, right? What is current extinction? This extinction of the current can occur in a valve if the current through it falls below the holding current. I think you must have heard with the characteristics of the thyristor. In case of characteristics of the thyristor, there are two important current. One is holding current and second is latching current. So extinction of the current can occur in a valve if the current through it fall below the holding current. This can arise at a low value of the bridge currents when any transient can lead to current extinction, right? So this problem, that is the problem of current extinction, is more severe in case of the short pulse firing method, right? In case of the short pulse firing method, this problem will become more severe. So in modern converter station, the return pulses coming from thyristor level to the valve group control indicate the buildup of voltage across the thyristor and initiate fresh firing pulses when the valve is supposed to be conducting, right? So it may happen that number of firing pulses may be generated during a cycle when the link current is low. That means whenever I am talking about the extinction of the current that can occur in a valve if the current through the valve will be fall below the holding current only. So by any means we are not going to this thyristor current that will not lead to below than this holding current, right? So these are see here, these are the characteristics of the VAK, minus VAK, IA and minus IA during the forward biasing condition. If we are not applying the gate pulse, if we are not applying the gate pulse, then these are the characteristics, because without applying this gate pulse, without applying the gate pulse, that thyristor will not conduct, right? And let us say at this particular point, I am just going to apply gate pulse IG. And then what will happen? That will be just a short circuit and current start rising sharply, right? So here this is your holding current IH, that is the minimum value of the current, that is the minimum value of the current which is required to thyristor turn on, which is required to thyristor turn on. If we want to just turn off the thyristor, if we want to turn off the thyristor, then this will be little bit low than this holding current, and that current is known as latching current. So for the commutation, we need the current in the thyristor must be larger than the holding current, right? If this current in the thyristor will be less than the holding current, then this may cause for the current extinction, right? Then further, this problem of the current extinction is more severe in case of the short pulse firing. Short pulse firing means when that firing will be taken place again and again, right? In that particular case, if in any case that short pulse firing will occur, then this may cause a great problem in the working of the converter. Now, in case of this your forward biasing condition, during the reverse biasing condition, this will be like this. Here it will be a reverse breakdown voltage BBO, right? So in case of either thyristor or in case of diode, even when we are not using gate, or we are using gate, right? During both of the condition, what will happen? This thyristor will not conduct. And if it will conduct, then it may cause for the damage of the thyristor or for the damage of the SCR. So during the reverse biasing condition, even after applying gate pulse, your thyristor will not conduct. And during the forward biasing condition, when we apply the gate pulse, suddenly your SCR comes as a short circuit. Current rises sharply. Without the gate pulse, one junction will always remain there. If you are aware with that construction of the PN junction, that SCR, PN, fine. So on this side, here it will be anode. On this side, this will be cathode. And here, it will be your gate, right? Anode, cathode, and gate. And as far as its symbol is concerned, this is the symbol of the anode, cathode, and gate. This is the symbol of the SCR, right? In this particular case, it is a three terminal, three junction, four layer device. These are junction J1, J2, J3. These are three junction of the device. These are three terminal, anode, cathode, and gate, right? And these are layer PN. So SCR or thyristor is a four layer, three terminal, three junction device, right? Which may be used to give the controlled output in case if we need uncontrolled, that either we will have to apply the firing pulse at the angle of 0 degree, or we may just use diode to apply the firing pulse at 0 degree. In that case, no doubt this SCR will be act as equivalent to the diode, but on the same time that will become uneconomical, right? This device will become uneconomical. Whatsoever purpose, if we will capable to solve that with the help of diode, we must solve that with the help of diode, because there is a huge difference between the cost of the SCR and cost of the diode. So whenever we are using thyristor instead of diode, then the cost of the system will increase, because we will have to set up that extra circuit for applying gate pulse, as well as we need extra circuit or extra components for the component which may be used to commutate the device, that means which may be used for the this you may say turn off the device, because in this particular case, in case of the SCR, it is not easy task to turn on the device as well as turn off the device for both of the purposes, that is for turn on the device as well as to turn off the device, we need extra component, we need extra circuit, which will increase the cost of the overall circuit, right? Which also need more space somewhat, you may say, right? So that means whenever we may utilize that diode in place of SCR, we must use that, right? It will be more economical in comparison, as far as cost point of view, it will be more economical to use diode instead of SCR in case of the inverter station. But for the faithful amplification or faithful application, we are preferred to use this SCR in place of diode, right? Because diode is a uncontrolled device, whereas this thyristor is a controlled device. By controlling the firing angle of the SCR, we will be able to control that overall output of the device, right? So this is the end of the lecture. We will meet in next lecture again.